Hey guys, it's Lucky Ghost here, and today we're going to talk about the Stamina Templar. I put together a solo Stamina Templar build, and it was everything I hoped it would be. It was simple, it was fun, it was incredibly powerful, and incredibly effective. I just ran it through veteran Bodhisattva Hollows, and it mopped up. This build was fun, it was powerful, and it was beautifully simple. If you've tried other builds and had a difficult time maintaining all the dots, keeping the uptime on those dots, then maybe try this build here. This is as simple as it gets. The main thing is that we get down a buff, a debuff, and then start jabbing like crazy. This build puts out just about as much damage as any of the other builds, and we're using 99% of the time, we're using one ability, our jabs. I was worried that surviving in Bodhisattva Hollows and other difficult solo arenas and other difficult solo content might be difficult. I was worried about incoming damage and how bad it was gonna hurt, especially when I got a few adds on me. But thanks to one of our abilities that provides major resolve and another ability, it wasn't a problem at all. This build tanked it all like a champion. We've got biting jabs bringing life back in. We've got our ring bringing life back in. And I never even had to think about stopping on the offense. I just went for it and it was great. It was a lot of fun. So let's talk about what makes this build tick. Let's get into the skills. All right, the first skill we have on the front bar is Barb Trap. We're putting this here. It's a nice little dot, which is great. It brings a little bit of life in every tick because of our Ring of the Pale order, but it's also, of course, very important for giving us minor force. That's going to be increasing our critical damage by 10%. Always nice. The next ability, Biting Jabs. This ability is insanely simple, powerful, and effective. There's only one downside to this ability, and then that's that it's a channeling ability, which means you cannot block cast it. So when you're fighting a boss and you need to block an attack, you're gonna need to make sure you hold block down, cancel your jabs, and block through that attack. Don't try to block cast with jabs, as you're gonna end up on the floor because you can't block cast a channeling ability. This ability launches a relentless assault, striking enemies in front of you. Yes, enemies plural. It's a cleave ability. It hits everything in front of you 4 times with your spear. The spear deals 5,000 physical damage to the closest enemy and 2,000 physical damage to all enemies near it. Each strike reduces the enemy movement speed of the closest enemy by 40%, and activating this ability grants you major savagery, increasing your weapon critical. So not only is this ability doing a ton of damage, it's also buffing you. It's also slowing your enemy. It's just a great ability. The next three abilities on the front bar are what we call bar buffers. They're fighter's guild abilities. And thanks to a fighter's guild passive called Slayer, increases your weapon damage by 3% for each fighter's guild ability slotted right here. For these abilities, when we're not even using them, right? They're just buffing biting jabs. So Silver Bolts, I don't ever use this ability. It's just there to look pretty and to buff my biting jabs. Camouflage Hunter, same thing. We don't ever use this ability. It's just here for the 3% extra damage. Ring of Preservation, same thing. However, this ability does have some utility. When I'm fighting a boss where I feel like I've got a lot of damage coming in and I just want to be a little bit safer, I throw this down on the ground because it does give you minor protection and increase my stamina recovery by 20%. And a little bit of a heal there, 781 health every half second. So that's actually not a bad heal over time. You get some damage mitigation. It's a great utility ability that you can put there and you can slam it down if you feel like you need to. Most times you definitely won't need to. And the next ability is Flawless Dawnbreaker. Arm yourself with Meridia's Sacred Sword and dispense her retribution, dealing damage to the enemies in front of you and increasing your weapon damage by 300 for 20 seconds. What are we buffing with this ability? You guessed it, biting jabs yet again. So if we look at our front bar, how many skills are buffing our biting jabs? Every single one, right? This is a fighter skill, Barb Trap, Silver Bolts, Camo Hunter, Ring of Preservation, and Flawless Dawnbreaker are all fighter skilled abilities. We're getting 3% from each one for a total of 15% increased weapon damage for biting jabs. Whenever we're on this bar, we're doing 15% more weapon damage. Huge, huge, And that's perfect because this is by far our primary source of damage on this build. Our gear is doing something similar. It's also buffing our biting jabs. We'll get there in a second. Now let's talk about the back bar. The back bar is where we've got some of our dots, our damage over time abilities, some utility abilities and buffs and things like that. This is kind of like the extracurricular section of our build. You can use it as much or as little as you feel is necessary, but it can be pretty helpful in adding a little bit more damage to your rotation. So the first ability we've got is Endless Hail. We're using the Maelstrom Bow. So this ends up doing a decent amount of damage. Plus it's a big AoE circle. So it's going to help you with adds when they're out. Not only that, but because we are wearing a ring of Pale Order, every dot that we cast is also a heal over time. It's a hot for ourselves, right? So stacking more dots is in our interest with that item. It's going to make it that much harder for us to die anytime we're able to keep more dots up. All right. Same thing with the next one, Poison Injection. This is a nice dot. It's also an execute ability. It's a dot that hits harder when the enemy is below 50% health. Same thing, anytime this is ticking on the enemy, it's also healing us, so it's nice to keep it up. Next, we've got Resolving Vigor. This is very much a flex ability. I found that I almost never needed it, but it was nice to have it in a pinch in case I didn't want to push on the boss. I wanted to roll away for a second, regather my composure. I could roll, dodge, pop a Resolving Vigor, and I'd be back at full health in absolutely no time at all. Power of the Light. Power of the Light is a very cool ability. It summons an expanding beam of pure sunlight to doom an enemy, dealing almost 5,000 physical damage to them and copying all the damage they take from you for 6 seconds and releasing 20% of it as additional physical damage to them. So basically what you do is you put this ability on your enemy and then you do as much damage to them as you can, and it calculates how much damage you do over the next 6 seconds and it slams them with 20% of that yet again, a maximum copied damage of up to 24,000 damage. Targets are also afflicted with Minor Breach, reducing their physical and spell resistance by almost 3,000 for 9 seconds. So as you can see, this ability is both a debuff and a dot. So how you're going to use this ability is you're going to get your dots ticking. So Endless Hail, Poison Inject, Barb Trap, get them all down. Throw your Power of the Light on while all of these are ticking already, right? And then you just jab for the next 6 seconds. Jab, jab, jab. That's going to maximize your damage output in those 6 seconds. Is if you're jabbing and your dots were already ticking. You don't want to have to take time to cast your dots after you cast your Power of the Light. You want to be jabbing with the dots already ticking. So you'll go Endless Hail, Poison Injection, Barb Trap, Power of the Light, and then just jab. There you go. Get your dots up, get your Barb Trap up, throw your Power of the Light on the enemy, and then jab until the 6 seconds is up, and repeat until the enemy is dead. The fifth ability on the back bar is Restoring Focus. This creates a rune of celestial protection. The rune grants you major resolve, increasing your physical resistance and spell resistance by almost 6,000. You also recover 240 stamina every second. Standing within the rune increases your physical resistance and spell resistance granted by 50%. This ability is what allows you to just basically turn off your brain and jab things to death. As long as this is on the floor and you're standing in it, you take so much less damage. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna slam it on the ground and you're gonna jab. And if you're worried, you can also slam down your fifth ability on the front bar. That's two defensive abilities. Both of them are healing you over time. Both of them are reducing the amount of damage coming in. And both of them are increasing the amount of stamina that you're recovering over time. Anytime both of those are down, you are absolutely a tank in front of your enemy. And as for the back bar ultimate, we've got Empowering Sweep. It does good damage in a large area in front of you. And after you use it, it increases the damage of your light and heavy attacks by 40%. All right, now let's talk about gear. The gear on this character is nice, simple, easy to get, and incredibly effective. First, we're going to be wearing the Damahas one piece on the head. This is going to give us maximum stamina and maximum magicka. We're going to wear 5 pieces of Deadly. Deadly gives us weapon damage, weapon critical, but the key piece of Deadly is that it increases the damage of our channeled abilities by 20%. Which ability are we using that's a channeled ability? Yeah, it's Jabs, right? That ability that we have 5 skills on our front bar buffing. So we've got 15% weapon damage on that bar while we're using biting jabs. We've got another 20% damage coming from Deadly Jack, turning jabs into an absolute monster. We're going to pair that with Vicious Ophidian. This is a fantastic solo set. It adds weapon critical, it adds minor slayer, increasing our damage by 5%, more weapon critical, more weapon damage, and then of course the 5 boost bonus, which reduces the cost of our abilities by 8%. It also restores stamina every time we kill an enemy and gives us major expedition, increasing our move speed by 30% every time we kill an enemy. The 5-piece buff is everything you could ever ask for while soloing. It gives you mobility, it gives you sustain, it's perfect. For the back bar, we've got the Maelstrom Bow. The Maelstrom Bow combined with Endless Hail is just going to help our cleave damage out a little bit more. We could have also gone with the Master's Bow to pair really well with our Poison Inject. Either one is going to work really well. Whichever one you have is totally fine. Most of our damage is going to be coming from our jabs anyway, but this extra damage from Endless Hail is nice to have. And last but not least, we're going to be wearing the Ring of the Pale Order. This is the newest mythic item added with Markarth, and this item is fantastic. It is so fun to use. It allows you to focus on staying on the offensive. Anytime you're attacking your enemy, you're very unlikely to die. You keep the pressure on, and that's your best defense. This ring has created an incredibly fun and rewarding playstyle. I'm really, really enjoying it. All right, as for our passives, we are going to take all of our class passives. It's very important that we are able to deal damage, tank damage, and heal through damage. So all of these end up being pretty useful. For the weapon skill lines, we are dual wield. So we're going to take all of the dual wield passives. We're using a bow, so we're going to take all of the bow passives as well. We're wearing 7 pieces of medium armor, so we are going to take all of the medium armor passives. We're going to take Undaunted Metal, the second Undaunted passive. We're going to take all of our class passives. And last but not least, we are going to take Medicinal Use level 3. The alchemy passive. For the Mundus, you have 2 options. You can either go Shadow or Lover. Shadow is going to increase your critical damage. Lover is going to increase your penetration. Shadow works better in group content. Lover is going to maybe work a little bit better in solo content. Both are going to work fantastic overall. As for our champion points, we're going to put 64 into Mighty, 61 into Piercing, 56 into Precise Strikes, 23 into Thaumaturge. We're going to put 66 into Master at Arms, 40 into Shadow Ward, 44 into Tumbling, 75 into Mooncalf, 56 into Tenacity, 5 into Bashing Focus, 19 into Sprinter, 31 into Warlord, 11 into Quick Recovery, 49 into Elemental Defender, 49 into Hardy, 48 into Thick Skinned, 32 into Spell Shield, and 81 into Ironclad. As for our consumables, we are going to use Dubious Cameron Throne for our food. This is going to give us stamina recovery. It's also going to give us max health and max stamina. As for our potions, anytime we're doing something sweaty, we're going to use Essence of Weapon Power. This is going to give us Major Brutality, which increases our weapon damage by 20%. It gives us Major Savagery, which we do have on the front bar, but we don't have on the back bar. So this will give it to us 100% of the time. It's also going to restore 7,582 stamina immediately and increase our stamina recovery by 40%. Anytime you're not doing something difficult, feel free to use the basic Essence of Stamina potions, as they will be more than fine. For the race, as this is a stamina DPS character, Orc is fantastic, Dark Elf, Wood Elf, and Redguard are also great runners-ups. Feel free to use any of them. This character here happened to be a Wood Elf because of some memes and chat, and that's what they wanted, so that's what they got, and it performed great. Okay, for our rotation for this build, what we're going to do is pre-buff. Then we're going to throw down our dots on the enemy, get our barb trap, get our Power of the Light, and then just go into our jabs until Power of the Light explodes. After Power of the Light explodes, we'll go ahead and start the process over. Throw down our dots, throw down our Power of the Light, and jab. And that wraps up the solo stamina Templar build. This build is more than capable of defeating veteran Bodhisattva Hollows. It will easily handle veteran Maelstrom Arena. Anything you want to solo in this game, this build can do it. and it will do it with simple and effective precision. The easiest rotation in the game, hands down. There's no better starter class. If you're looking for a nice, easy way to get into this game, looking for a character with a nice, easy rotation, don't look any farther than the Stamina Templar. It's as easy as it gets, and it's incredibly fun, and you're not giving up any sort of power in the process. It's just as strong, if not stronger, than the rest of the classes. So give this one a try. You're gonna love it. You're gonna have a fun time, I promise. And let me know what you think. I'm Lucky Ghost. I stream ESO 5 days a week, so be sure to swing by my stream at twitch.tv/LuckyGhostTV. I look forward to seeing you there. If you're ever looking for the written guide for this build or any other build, be sure to check out eso.justlootit.com or written guides, build guides, guide guides, and all the guides and more. And of course, if you have not yet subbed, please, please be sure to hit that sub button. Be sure to hit the like button. It helps me out a ton. I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Until then, guys, have a fantastic day, night, or evening, wherever you might be. Until next time.